So if you look at, you have that little pointer? Okay, this guy has to reach forward, and you see that his mouse is positioned up on his desktop, not next to the keyboard over here. That would be a much better position for it. This guy's in much better condition. Can you guys see with me standing over here? Okay. Some of the new fancy keyboards that are coming out with have adjustable negative slopes so that you can prevent keeping the wrist bent up too far. And you can see here in a conventional keyboard, you have this kind of angle, an upward position of your wrist, and a negative slope keyboard will help keep that wrist in a straight position. There's also hazards in the side-to-side position of your wrist. Although these don't contribute quite as much as the up and down bending, they also need to be considered. So you may have seen some of those new fancy keyboards that are split and tented and round and concave at Home Depot, no, Office Depot. And I'm going to just do a brief discussion of those. But what we want to avoid is that very lifted up position. We want to avoid keeping the elbows out at the side. We want to even avoid sideways bending of the wrist, although that's not as big of a factor. And we also want to keep the forearms in a neutral position. So here's a couple of alternative keyboards. This is a split and rotated design, and this is a split and tented design. And they're designed to straighten the wrist. They increase the distance between the right and the left side. So if you're here on your keyboard, you can see how my hands are kind of pointing inwards. If they're spread apart, and I have a more neutral position of my forearms and wrist in relation to the keyboards. And the tented keyboards let you turn your hands out a little bit. So to be in this position, if you all try that, putting your hands all the way with your palms facing down, you can feel that there's a little bit of stress there. And if you let them just fall out a little ways, it's a little more comfortable. So this is something, if you're going to invest in an alternative keyboard, it's a good thing to try out first. Different people have different reactions. They're hard to get used to, so there are pros and cons. But those are the theories behind why they're beneficial. Other options for maintaining the wrist straight are a wrist rest like this. And there's some controversy about that as well, because there's some feeling that if you have the wrist rest, you're going to put additional pressure on that carpal tunnel. So again, it's a personal issue. And some people find the trackball better than a regular mouse in terms of not having to rest their hands on a surface. And this is one that I haven't seen before, except for as I was researching this for our talk tonight, but it's a platform that rotates above the keyboard and is supposed to be very ergonomically correct. And I saw it in some catalogs, and I'm going to give you references for some catalogs later, and you'll be able to see all of these. Yeah. Are you familiar with them? Because I haven't seen them in real life. Okay. Injuries are not caused by keyboards alone. High risk activity. We're going to look at it in relation to chairs and monitors and a couple of other things. You want to look at your chair. Properly designed and adjusted chair will provide appropriate support to the back, the legs, the buttocks, and the arms. And if it's properly supportive, it'll reduce the contact stress. Like if you have a chair with like hard edges, then you're going to feel uncomfortable in the back of your thighs. So you want to try to increase your comfort all around so that you'll be able to maintain a good position. Improper size, a bad choice of materials, for the seat pan or the backrest can result in discomfort, and that's going to make